Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. Today what I've got is a whole lesson plan for you. This is great for language teachers, but it could actually be used for almost any kind of area of the curriculum. It's really about getting our students to introduce themselves or to present somewhere special, somewhere they like. I'm going to combine working with two free tools, Google Earth and Wordwall. And what you're going to see is that this technology is lovely because it really does open up loads of opportunities for students to do speaking activities and to present themselves or present somewhere special to them, perhaps where they went on holiday, where they went to school, where they were born, their favorite cafe, their favorite gym, a monument they like in their town or in another town. I've used this in so many ways and I've seen students do such fantastic presentations using Google Earth. So this is a whole lesson plan. You'll get lots of ideas from it. It's really worth watching it through and seeing all the different ideas that I share with you. I really hope you like the video, and if you do, please like it. Please share it with other teachers and help me to build my YouTube channel. And of course, please comment on it. Let's get started. So there's lots of ways that I've used Google Earth, and I'm going to show you how Google Earth works. So it's one of your apps, okay? And the very first time I used it was with a group of boys in Italy. I was going over to Italy to do some practice lessons. And so what I thought was that I would start my lesson by introducing them to my favorite football club. Now, I've used this idea many times since, just as a way of introducing myself. And say, right, I'm going to introduce myself to you and let you know a little bit about me. So I come over to Stamford Bridge, which is the home of my favourite football club, Chelsea. Notice you can just close it like that. And then if you notice, you can go 2D view. And when you do 2D view, it starts spinning round. And you can also, sorry, that's 3D view. And then you can click on 2D view, and that's from the top. Remember, if you click on 3D view, it starts spinning round. But you can stop it at any point. Now what I do is I do a little presentation where I just talk about Stamford Bridge and how I often go there, and I explain a little bit about the history of the football club. It's Chelsea. They were formed in 1905. I first went to a football match in 1972. I tell them a little bit about where it's situated, that it's in Fulham, not in Chelsea, and I show them that Chelsea is over here. You can hold your mouse down and move around. You can also move out and move in. Now, I just do a little introduction and introduce myself. And then one final thing that I do, and I just want to show you this because this is kind of really nice. If we come back to 3D view, and as I said, it kind of spins around and it gives you this great view of the area. And you can remember, anytime you click on the screen, it will actually stop. So it's great for doing presentations. You know, you can present all sorts of places. Just to give you some examples, I've visited Sydney Opera House. I've visited Empire State Building. I've gone off to where I went on holiday in Thailand. I've gone off to Bali. But notice you can grab the little guy here. And actually, if you just do it really slowly, you just hold your mouse down and pick him up. And then you can drop him down. So what I actually do is I show people where I walk into the stadium, and it comes right down onto the screen. So this is really a good way of doing a little presentation that's got a really nice interest. And people can present anything because they can actually come down to street level, and they can even, for example, start by presenting the area where they were born and even show people the house that they were born in. You can come down to street level. So what I do is I do a little presentation about Chelsea, and then I give the students an exercise to do, and next I'm going to show you that exercise. Now what you could do is you could do the presentation at the end of the lesson, but then for homework the students have to first of all do this activity to check they followed your presentation, and then afterwards they can prepare their own presentation for the next lesson. And the activity that I created was in this website called Wordwall. You can sign up to Wordwall for free. And in this one, all about Chelsea, all the students have to do is just, and I'll just quickly show you the game. So the game works like this, where you have to go sort of right, Chelsea Stadium, is Stamford Bridge. Chelsea was founded in 1905, etc. So you drag the correct answers in. Once you've completed all your answers, you simply click on submit and it gives you the answers. Now the good thing is that it actually tracks the students when they do this as well. So what you can do afterwards, and I'll quickly show you, is if I go to the results and I look at one of the activities I've done about Chelsea, and I've used it quite a few times, so I'm sure I can find an example. Let me just come down here. Okay, here, for example, I can click on the results and I can see which questions the students got right and which questions they got wrong, and it even tells me a breakdown of where students made mistakes. So this is the activity I do immediately after the presentation, either in the class, you could do it in the class, or you could do it with the students as for homework. Now, how do you actually set the activity for the students? Well, it's really easy. All you do is choose the activity, you obviously make the activity, click on share, and then just click on set assignment, click on start, and you share that link with the students, okay? And then the students can do the activity. So you could share that link for the students to do for homework, or could be in the class. If you're doing a Zoom session or using perhaps Microsoft Teams, just share the link in the chat room. So just to show you how I made that activity, the activity that I used, if you click on create activity, the one I used was match up, so the very first one there. And if we come back to the activities and we click on all about Chelsea, all I did, if we could edit content, you'll see how easy it is, I just wrote sentences, so simple. Just wrote out the sentences, complete these sentences, and then I clicked on done. So it's really easy to use this technology. And as I said, once you've clicked on the done button, to share the activity, all you need to do so that your students can use the activity is click on share, click on set assignment. I always ask them to put their name in and then click on start. And then you copy that, share the link. And don't forget, you can get the results from here once they've done the activity. Now the third part of the activity is for the students then to prepare their own presentations. And this for me has worked really well. So I tell students, okay, you now present somewhere. Now that could be a place that you visited or went on holiday, your favorite place in the city that you live in, or anything. It could be the coffee bar they go to, a monument they like, a museum that they enjoy visiting, a place that they've gone for a visit. It really doesn't matter where they were born, where they went to school. I've had students do all sorts of presentations, and it's absolutely brilliant because they can go to Google Earth and find a place that they can present. And let me just show you one final thing about Google Earth. Now you can be really accurate. I'm gonna try and do something. I'm gonna write in Ao Nang Krabi. And hopefully it's gonna bring me down to, in fact it is, it's gonna bring me right down to the area. Let's just click on this one here. Okay, so it's gonna bring me into that actual place where I went on holiday about 4 or 5 years, one of my favorite holiday locations, and it brings me in to that area. Now I'm just going to close that down. Now what I can do now is I can actually come in even closer, so I can just click on here and bring myself in as close as possible to the region. And if I want to, and I know where I need to go, look at this, I'm just going to show you where I went on holiday, so I can come right down and just click, and now that I've got this close to the area, what I can do now, incredibly, is I can take my little man and see that I can even drop myself onto the beach. Okay, so I'm gonna just come down right onto this beach here. And now I come right down to the level, and this gives you a bit of an idea of where I was. Okay, absolutely fantastic to be able to do that. Okay, so you could do that with the place you were born, where you went to school, the place that you went on holiday. So this is a great way of getting your students to, and it's very nice because it's personalizing language. So really love working with Google Earth, but then it's always nice to think what are you going to ask the students to do while they listen to the other student doing a presentation? Are they going to take notes? Okay, so maybe then they've got to take notes and learn five things about the student, or learn five things about where the presentation, that kind of thing. Think carefully about what you're going to ask the students to do. But working with Google Earth is really, really powerful. And it's something that I've done with really young learners, okay, even as young as 13, 14, and they've done presentations about their favorite football teams when I was out in Italy. And very, you know, with adults who are just literally presenting one special place on planet Earth that they want to show and talk about to everyone else. And I give the students about 4 minutes or 5 minutes each to do their presentations. I hope that was useful. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com if you want more free technologies. On the opening page, I always add some special ones here about language teaching, some of the most popular ones, but there's also a language teaching section that you can make use of with loads and loads of different free tools available, not only for English, but also for other languages as well. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is sign up to the newsletter. You get a free mini course in using technology in teaching, and you get updates on all the latest videos, the latest blogs, the latest online courses, and the latest webinars. The other thing that you can do is follow me on my YouTube channel, and don't forget to click on the bell to get the updates. And finally, if you were thinking of asking me to do a presentation or some training at your organization, then you can contact me from the website. And thank you very much. I hope that was useful. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com if you want more free technologies. On the opening page, I always add some special ones here about language teaching, some of the most popular ones, but there's also a language teaching section that you can make use of with loads and loads of different free tools available, not only for English, but also for other languages as well. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is sign up to the newsletter. You get a free mini course in using technology in teaching, and you get updates on all the latest videos, the latest blogs, the latest online courses, and the latest webinars. The other thing that you can do is follow me on my YouTube channel, and don't forget to click on the bell to get the updates. And finally, if you were thinking of asking me to do a presentation or some training at your organization, then you can contact me from the website. And thank you very much.